beautiful people, welcome again to another exciting episode of Vibes, your number one entertainment recap show. I'm Rejoice Eljage, as always, tracking the trends for you and bringing you the juiciest stories in the world of showbiz. Without further ado, let's get right into it. We begin our trends this week with some exciting news for pop star David Adeleke, aka Davido, whose 2017 single Fall has been certified gold in the US and Canada. Davido took to Twitter to share the good news to the delight of his fans. This feat means that the single has sold the equivalent of 40,000 and 800,000 copies in Canada and the US respectively. Way to go, Davido! Rave of the moment, Nairomally has joined the online concert trend occasioned by the COVID-19 lockdown. He announced that he would be hosting the free concert to mark the Marleyan Day later today, May the 30th. The online show will be the first of its kind for the artist during the lockdown, and it's expected to feature his hit tracks such as Soapy, Teshumole, and several others. Also expected to feature on the show are fellow singers World, Zlatan, and others. In what is generally believed to be another big win for Afrobeats in the global music space, Nigerian female disc jockey and performing artist DJ Cuppy has been announced as the host for Apple Music's first radio show in Africa, and this takes our second spot on the trends. The show called Africa Now Radio with Cuppy will debut on Sunday, May the 31st, and will feature a mix of contemporary and traditional popular African sounds, including genres like Afrobeat, rap, house, and more. This is coming off the back of an impressive run for African music, especially Nigerian Afrobeat, within the global music space. Acts like Drake and Beyonce have borrowed the Afrobeat sound for their own songs, while performers like Davido, Burna Boy, Tiwa Savage, Wizkid, and Mr. Easy continue to gain attention and have become household names in the United States and the UK. And our top story for the week is the controversy surrounding Nigerian dancehall singer Cynthia Morgan and her disappearance from the music scene. Earlier in the week, a movement to bring the German Juice singer back to the music scene took over the trends after an Instagram live interview in which she opened up about her challenges over the past couple of years. Morgan, who now goes by the moniker Madrina, revealed that she fell out with her former label head Jude Okoye, who is the older brother to the now defunct group P-Square. She also alleged that Okoye took over her Instagram and Vevo accounts and stopped her from using already popular stage name Cynthia Morgan. According to her, while dealing with all that, she relocated to Benin, where she later fell ill. Since the interview went viral, fans and colleagues, including pop star Davido, have reached out to her, reinforcing the Bring Back Cynthia Morgan movement. But clearly displeased by the revelations, Okoye took to social media to release details of her contract with his label, a move that immediately sparked the trend So Cynthia Morgan lied. Morgan has, however, written an open letter to clear the air, saying she never lied about the events, but only shared things from her own point of view, while admitting that she may have erred just like everyone else who had contributed to her brand. She thanked Okoye for giving her the platform. She also thanked her fans for the support so far, as well as her colleagues who have reached out to her. Hopefully the dust settles and she can return to the spotlight pretty soon. And to music, Reason With Me crooner Paul Okoye, aka Rude Boy, is back with another single titled Woman. The song tackles the subject of relationships. It also preaches that no one is perfect and couples can only work together to build the kind of relationship that will be perfect for them. Away from Nigeria and to some not-so-cherry news, Guinean singer Mori Kante, who helped introduce African music to a world audience in the 1980s, has died. His son, Bala Kante, revealed on May the 22nd that Mori had died at a hospital in the country's capital, Conakry, at the age of 70 after succumbing to untreated health problems. According to Bala, Mori suffered from chronic illnesses and often traveled to France for treatment, but that was no longer possible since the emergence of the coronavirus, and consequently, his condition deteriorated rapidly until he passed on. Kante is best known for his dance song Yeke Yeke, which was a huge hit in Africa before becoming a number one in several European countries in 1988. Along with Mali's star singer Salif Keita, his songs were amongst the first from West Africa to receive widespread success elsewhere in the world. Condolences have poured in for the singer, and we also extend ours to his family and fans. And in the world of movies, after years of being in the political space, former senator representing Kogi West local government Dino Melaye is set to take Nollywood by storm. The senator, who had been embroiled in various controversies in the past year, took to Instagram to announce the upcoming production along with a teaser poster of the movie titled The Bean-Shaped Hero. Written by Ade Fakponle, the movie tells the story of a man whose happy life is cut short by a kidney condition. It also features former Big Brother Naija housemate Diane Rosset, and we can't wait to see it when it's finally out.
You have the autosomal dominant polycystic kidney disorder.
It's so nice to see you. How are you doing?
And finally, to fashion, Congolese designer Anifa Mwemba has given us a preview of what runway fashion might look like in the post-pandemic world. Mwemba released the latest collection for her fashion brand Hanifa on Instagram Live last Friday using virtual models. We don't know about you guys, but we were totally mind-blown. During the show, the digital models strutted down the runway with the designer's outfits draped on headless three-dimensional bodies. The Pink Label Congo collection featured pants and dresses in vibrant colors, and it really was a delight to watch. But beyond the innovation, the designer says the collection was her way of raising awareness about the sad plight of Congolese cobalt miners, who are mostly women and children. That's an amazing one right there, and hopefully it helps to shed some light and also garner support for the affected women and children in Congo. Well, that's where we wrap up the show for today. I hope you enjoyed it just as much as I did. You can head over to our website www.channelstv.com for details of all our top stories, and also subscribe to our YouTube channel so you don't miss any of our content. I'll see you again same time next week. Until then, please stay safe.